kings and aces are high. Make the wrong call and you'll go bye-bye on Card Shark. And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Yeah, I'm still doing my Long John Silver invitation. My tennis wounds. Thank you very much. Welcome to Card Sharks. And the opening poem, we thank Bill Bowling of Albany, Georgia. And make the wrong call, you'll go bye-bye. I hope this lady doesn't, because she's going for the big money with the money cards. Let's bring out our champion, Kathy Gorsline. Hello, Kathy. Nice to have you here again. Congratulations on your birthday yesterday. You won the championship. Isn't that nice?
I feel fantastic. I'm back to collect my prize.
That's good. Won't you again tell us about yourself?
Well, I'm Kathy Gorsline. I'm originally from Anchorage, Alaska. I am now living in Salem, Oregon with my fantastic husband, my 14-month-old daughter, and I'm still on my honeymoon.
That's good. How long have you been married?
5 years.
5 years and still on the hunt. That's terrific. That's good. Kathy, you won $200 for winning the game, and now you're going for the big dollars. Are you ready?
I am ready in my second airline bought dress.
Now let's get to the money cards. Come on, Kathy. Up here. Yes, that's right. They lost your luggage. Still haven't found your luggage.
Haven't found it. It's snowed in somewhere,
well,
I guess.
Well, you're going out and buying clothes. That's nice.
It's
here come
bad.
The money cards, all shuffled and cut. We'll give you $200 and these three cards on the bottom line. Move up to the second level. We'll give you another $200 and three more cards. Your minimum risk is $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, and there you must risk at least half the money. Good luck, Kathy. There's
Thank
a lot
you.
Of money up there. Let's pay for
I'm
a whole
going
wardrobe.
For it.
Here's $200. And remember, you can change your base card on each of the three levels. You're starting with a seven.
Seven.
Do you want it?
Change that card. I don't like
Must
sevens.
Must play this one. Next card off the top of the deck is a
two.
Good card.
Right. $200 higher than a two.
All of it.
All
$200
of it.
Higher than the two. Yes,
Woo!
A nine.
Okay. I'm going to bet $100 it's lower than a nine.
$100 lower than a nine. Yes, a five. Up to $500.
Okay, I'm going to bet $200 higher than a five.
$200 higher than a five. Oh, no, a three. Down to $300, but up goes that good card, the three.
That's
we'll give you the
card.
Other $200 of betting
All
money.
Right.
Back to
$500. $500. $400, it's higher than a three.
$400 higher than a three. With an eight. $900,
okay.
But be careful, you're up the middle.
Okay, I don't like eights. I'm going to go $100. It's lower.
$100 lower.
Lower.
Ooh, I hope you're right. We're looking at a lot of low cards there, Kathy. $100 lower than an eight.
Oh,
it's a queen.
Okay, that's all right.
We didn't see any face cards.
That's all right.
Down to 800 with a queen.
800, 700, lower.
$700 lower than a queen. With a three, good card. And you've got 1,500, and again, a good card goes up for the big bet.
Oh, I can't lose with this. I'm going to go all of it higher.
All or nothing.
All of it higher.
If this is higher than a three, you'll have $3,000 to buy that wardrobe for the win higher. Come on. $3,000. Way to go, Kathy. Atta girl. Way to go. Congratulations. Did that pay for the clothes?
That paid for it. Paid for my way home, and my husband's coming with me.
Kathy Gorsline with $3,200 will meet a new challenger right after this commercial break. Congratulations. Good card. All right, Kathy, we're going to open the board and get to the cards right now. And Kathy, as Janice and Bettina come in to load in two brand new decks of cards, we'll meet your next challenger on Card Sharks. Roberta Williams. Hello, Roberta. Nice to have you here.
Thank you. It's fun to be here.
Won't you tell us about yourself, ma'am?
Yes, I'm Roberta Williams. I have been a school teacher, counselor, and administrator in schools for 25 years. I've been married 42 years.
Congratulations.
And I have two children and five grandsons.
That's nice.
Incidentally, my youngest grandson, his birthday is today.
Oh.
So I'm going to win a whole bunch for him.
Well, it was yesterday, Kathy's birthday. It was very lucky for her. Let's see how it is for you, Roberta. Have you cut your cards?
Yes.
Then we are all set to go. Good luck.
Thank you.
And each player has their own deck of cards. Shuffle, the players cut them. Kathy, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red deck. Roberta, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue deck. And we start the best two out of three match with a question to you, Kathy. Kathy, we found 100 teenage girls who are babysitters and asked them, Have the children you were babysitting ever tied you up? How many babysitters said they've been tied up?
I myself have babysat some pretty feisty little children, but I don't know. I don't think they're that bad anymore. I think the babysitters use psychology and keep them entertained, so I'm going to say about 30.
30 have been tied up by the kids. Oh.
Well, I've done a lot of babysitting in my younger days, but I've never been tied up, and I just don't think that that many would have been tied up. It's got to be lower.
So you say lower.
Lower.
If it is lower, you'll get to play your cards first, Roberta. If not, it'll be Kathy. And the actual number of babysitters who've been tied up by the kids is 18. Very much lower. Roberta, yes. You know, the question I'd really like to know is how many babysitters have gotten so mad they'd like to tie up the kids.
That's what. That's a different
Roberta,
question.
You're starting with a 4.
Oh. I want to go keep that card and go higher.
Higher than a 4? Yes, a 5.
Once more, I'm going to go higher.
Risking it again, higher than a 5. It is, look at that, 4, 5, 6.
Let's go higher. One more time.
One more time. Higher than a 6. Yes, and a 7. 3 different suits, but 4, 5, 6, 7.
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it. Yeah, get near that middle range there, Roberta. And Roberta needs one card for the first game of the match. Your first question, Roberta. We asked 100 married women. Has your husband ever said something to you that was so sweet and so romantic that it made you cry? Aw. How many women said that's happened to them?
Oh, well, it's happened to me a number of times.
It has.
I've got to believe that it happened to a lot. Let's say 55.
55. Do you recommend it as a reason why you've stayed married for 42 years?
Maybe. I don't know.
55 women, their husbands have said something so sweet and romantic it made them cry, Kathy.
I think it's... my husband does it to me all the time. He's a romanticist, and I think that it's a little bit higher. I think
even higher. Have you cried something sweet?
I have cried. It's been so sweet.
The actual number of married women whose husband has said something so sweet it made them cry is 59. It is a little higher. Kathy, yes. And your first look at your base card. Kathy, you've got an ace. Great card.
An ace lower than an ace.
Lower than the ace. A 10.
Oh, 10. I'm going to try and go lower than a 10.
Risking it lower than that 10? Yes, 9.
I think I'll freeze on a 9.
And Kathy needs 2 cards. Roberta needs 1. Question 3 goes to you, Kathy. Kathy, we asked 100 men who worked as department store Santa Claus. And we said, now be honest, is that big belly really all yours? How many department store Santas said the big belly was really all theirs?
Oh, gosh. I think that even if it was theirs, they wouldn't want to admit it, because Santa has a pretty big belly. So I'm going to say about 40.
40? Didn't use any padding. The belly was theirs, Roberta.
Well, I've known quite a few men that have been Santa Clauses. And no, I don't think so. It just has to be lower.
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 You figure it's more padding than real.
Yeah, more padding.
The actual number of department store Santas whose big belly was their own is 41. Not lower by 1, Kathy. Boy, Kathy, you almost hit that right on the head. You've got a 9.
I've got to change that 9.
You won the question. Change you have the right to change it. 2. A
3. Higher than a 3.
Higher than a 3. Yes, sir.
You're
going to freeze. Okay. Kathy's going to freeze. Kathy needs 1. Roberta needs 1. And sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. And with both players needing 1 card, control is so very important. Roberta, we asked 100 married women. Do you consider your husband a success in business? How many women said yes, they do?
Oh, I just wouldn't stay married to a man if I didn't feel that he was a success. It just, I think you have to have confidence. I would say 65.
65. What do you think, Kathy?
Well, could you repeat the question?
Surely. 100 married women. We asked them, do you consider your husband a success in business? How many women said yes, they do consider their husband a success?
I think it's definitely higher because they need to encourage him, and they're going to encourage him any way they have.
So you say higher.
Yeah, higher.
For that all-important control, the actual number of proud married women who consider their husband a success is 80. Kathy, it is higher. I'll tell you something that occurred to me, though, Roberta, when you were saying about you'd have to feel that. I'd sure rather that they felt a success in life than a success in business. Kathy,
right.
You've got an 8. You need one card. Roberta, you've got a 7. You need one. Kathy, do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to play it and change the 8.
And it's a big change because this will be for the win. It is a 5.
Oops.
Oh, excuse me. It is Kathy. Woo. Yes, and it is Kathy's card, incidentally. Thank you, Janice. I just put it in the wrong place. The 5 goes here.
5. I tell you, I'm going to go with the odds and say higher.
Higher.
Higher than
Kathy,
5.
Kathy, if this is higher, you've got the first game of the match. If it is not higher, Roberta wins it. For the win, no, it's not higher, and Roberta wins it in sudden death. Oh! Game 1 to the challenger. And we'll set up for game 2 coming up right after this commercial break. So the challenger won game 1 and $100. Janice is dealing out the same 2 decks of cards as we start game 2 with a question to Kathy, the champion. Kathy, we asked 100 third graders in Ohio, have you ever gotten sick on your school bus? How many third graders said, yeah, they've gotten sick on the school bus?
Oh, gosh. I suppose it does happen occasionally. I think I'll say about 25.
25 third graders in Ohio got sick on the school bus. You were a teacher, Roberta. What do you think?
Well, kids are prone to get sick when they have a cold, that's true, but it just has to be lower.
Lower than, you don't think it was that many, though?
No, I don't think that many.
The actual number of third graders who've gotten sick on a school bus is 28, not lower. Kathy. And again, Kathy was very close to the right answer. Kathy, you've got a 4.
4. I'm going to go with a 4, and I'm going to say it's higher than a 4.
Higher than a 4. Yes,
all
a
right.
King.
All right, keep the king and lower.
Lower than a king. It is an 8.
Freeze on that 8.
Isn't it amazing how when people see an 8, it's an automatic freeze? Can't say as I blame you. That is the middle card. Roberta, we asked 100 single women. Have you ever lied and said you had a date for New Year's Eve when you really didn't? How many women admitted they've lied about having a New Year's Eve date? Isn't that sad, Roberta?
Well, I just think that you just have to do that once in a while, you know, even against your better judgment. So it'd have to be 58.
58 have lied and said they had a date for New Year's Eve when they really didn't.
No, I think it's much lower than that. I think New Year's Eve is so special that everybody has a date on New Year's.
Oh.
Yeah, everybody, almost.
Your reasoning was the opposite of mine, Kathy. Let's see. The actual number of women who have lied about having a New Year's Eve date is... But you were right, 25, Kathy. It's lower. I don't know how you arrived at that answer, but you arrived there. You've got an 8.
Change that 8. Get rid of that.
Changing the 8 to a 6.
6. I'll go higher than a 6.
Higher than a 6. Yes,
oh,
queen.
Lower than a queen.
To tie up the match, lower than the queen. No, it's a king. And you lose both cards back to the 6, and Roberta gets her first look at her base card, a jack.
Oh, we got to go lower.
Lower than a jack. It is a 3.
Oh, great card. Let's go higher.
Higher than a 3. Oh, no, a 2. And again, with a good card, you could not take advantage of it, and Janice will fill in the spaces. Kathy. Question goes to you. We asked 100 people. Now, tell the truth. This past Christmas, did you have to go shopping the day before Christmas? How many people admitted they did?
Oh, that's got to be high. I myself always end up shopping Christmas Eve. So I'm going to say about 70.
70 have had to do their shopping just the day before Christmas, Roberta.
Oh, I have to every year because I forget something. It has to be a little bit higher.
Higher than that,
either. A little bit.
The actual number of people who've had to go shopping the day before Christmas is 59, not higher. Kathy. Yes, I had to do that, but I went out and got a 300-piece dinner suit for our producer, Jonathan Goodson. I bought him a box of toothpicks. Kathy, you've got a 6.
Change the 6 for sure.
And see, now you don't trust me. You don't want to give it to me, Janice, right? She wants to change the 6 to
a jack. Lower than a jack.
Lower than the jack. Oh, no, it's a queen again. And again, Roberta with a free chance to play off the jack.
Okay, let's go lower.
Lower than a jack. No. And neither player could advance, and we are at sudden death. Kathy needs 2 cards. Roberta needs 4. And this will be for the marbles in this game. Roberta,
We asked 100 married women, have you ever forgotten you were supposed to meet your husband and left him standing on a street corner? How many women admitted they have?
Well, I've never done anything like that. I just don't, I just don't think not many have done it. Maybe 18.
18 have left him standing on the corner.
Oh, I think it's even lower than that. I think they would be pretty definite that they would try to meet him. Even
and lower. The actual number of married women who've forgotten to meet their husband is 14. It's lower. Kathy. Kathy, big decision. You've got a jack. You need two cards. Roberta also has a jack. She needs four. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to pass it.
All right, Roberta, if you get them all, you are the new champion. One mistake and Kathy ties up the match. With a jack, call this one.
For the third time, let's go lower.
Lower than a jack. And this time it is with an eight.
Okay, we've got to go lower again.
Lower than an eight. No, it's not lower. And Kathy ties it up in sudden death. So each player has one game and $100. We'll set up for the tiebreaker with just three cards up there. Three questions here. Kathy, we start with a question to you. We ask 100 single women, would you accept a diamond ring from a man you did not love? How many women said they would accept a diamond ring?
Oh, I do believe that's happened. I'm going to say about 35.
35 women have accepted or would accept a diamond ring from a man they did not love, Roberta.
Oh, I just wouldn't do it. I just can't believe that many women would do it. It just has to be lower.
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 The actual number of single women who would accept a diamond ring from a man they didn't love is 38. Oh! Lower. Kathy. Kathy and the tiebreaker, you start with a seven.
Change that seven.
You won the question, you can change it. An ace. Straight card.
Lower than an ace.
Lower than an ace. A two. For the championship, higher, yes! And Kathy pulls it out with two wins in a row. Roberta, thank you for joining us. You're a lovely lady. And Kathy, come on down here with me, and we'll be right back right after this. Congratulations. Back with our champion, Kathy Gorsline. Another $200 for winning the game.
It's great. It's great.
Yours to keep. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Then let's get to the money cards. Come on, Kathy. Go on for the big money. And Janice and Bettina, if you will, start dealing out the cards. And once again, the money cards have been shuffled and cut. Brand new deck of cards. Seven cards up there. And you know if you can double it all the way up, there's $28,800 that could possibly be won right there.
My new home.
Your new home. I hope you do it. Here's $200, Kathy. And we'll start you off this time with...
A jack.
Do you want it?
Good card. I'm going to say 200. It's lower than a jack.
Whole thing, $200 lower than a jack. Yes, with a six, $400.
Okay, I'm going to take 100 and go higher.
$100, risking it higher than a six. And an ace. Great card.
500, I'm going to say all of it lower.
$500 lower than an ace. Yes, with a six. And even $1,000 on that level. Up goes the six.
Oh,
for $200 more, you've got $1,200.
Let's change the six.
Anytime you move up, you can change it. So you've got a king. Great card.
I'm going to go $1,000 lower.
All of it?
$1,000
lower. You're going to hold back $200. $1,000 lower than a king. The jack. $2,200, Kathy.
I'm going to say... Lower.
$2,000 on the jack.
I feel good. It's lower.
I hope you're right. $2,000 lower than a jack. No.
I shouldn't have felt
down
that good.
Down to 200.
200. 100 higher.
$100 higher?
I mean lower. Lower.
You're still shaking from
nervous.
That 2,000,
yeah.
Kathy. $100 lower than a queen. It is a
All
10.
Right.
300.
I'm going to change the 10.
And as we move it up, you want to change it.
Didn't change the 10.
Changing the 10 to a two.
A
great card. Oh, if you only had all that betting money.
It's got to be higher.
$300 higher than a two. Yeah, for $600.
That's all right. That's good.
Oh, Kathy. Why did you bet so much on the jack?
I just had a hunch.
Well, I guess you got to follow your feelings. Come on down here, Kathy. But nonetheless, you're up to $4,000. That's not bad. We'll be right back right after this commercial break, so don't go away. We need you. Will our gambling champion, Kathy Gorsline, will meet a new challenger when next we meet on Card Sharks. Have a nice day. Bye-bye for now.
A representative of the studio audience will receive Hamilton Beach's new espresso coffee maker. Brews 1-4 demi-tasse espresso cups in a carafe. Convenient on-off switch. Double spout nozzle fills 2 separate cups furnished by Hamilton Beach Scoville. And some of our contestants will receive Edison Comfort Sensor Room Heater. 3 heat levels, 2-speed fan. Features built-in 24-hour multi-programmable timer automatically controls heat. And a handsome fireplace set in 12 Sterno Logs Easy Lighter. No newspaper kindling needed. 1 match lights a 3-hour Sterno log. And a gift certificate from Ben Franklin Stores. We carry national brands at prices you like. Discover Ben Franklin. We bring variety to life. And 6 passes to see Robert Shaw, Harrison Ford, Barbara Bach, Edward Fox, Franco Nero, and Carl Weathers in the electrifying adventure Force 10 from Navarone, coming to theaters this Christmas. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.